Chancellor of the American University of Sharjah, Dr. Roland Jeffer, is not here tonight as he's traveling to China. He asked that I extend his best wishes and congratulations to each of our outstanding students. Let me begin this evening ceremony by introducing the members of the stage party. I ask that you stand as I announce your name. Dr. York Way, Dean of the School of Business Administration. Dr. Richard Schuforster, Dean of the College of Engineering. Dr. Mahmoud Manatawi, Vice Provost for Undergraduate Affairs and Studies. Dr. Mohammed El Tarhouni, Vice Provost for Graduate Studies. Ms. Linda Ataya, the Registrar. And Dr. Martin Giesen, our guest speaker, whom I will introduce momentarily. Dr. Giesen is also here on behalf of Dr. Marky Paul-Mutual, Dean of the College, Architecture and Design. At an event like this takes an enormous amount of work and coordination. I would specifically like to thank the Registrar, Linda Ataya, and her colleagues in the Office of the Registrar for their hard work in organizing the Honors Convocation. Please join me in thanking them. Also, please welcome my other colleagues here on the stage, Chief Operating Officer Jeanette Binkley, Associate Deans, as well as the heads of the academic departments of the university. Would you please stand and recognize? It is a particular honor to introduce you to the faculty and staff of the American University of Sharjah, who have come to celebrate with the students as they see recognition this evening. Let us thank you. Finally, and most importantly, I would like to introduce the students whom we honor tonight. There are many privileges that the Provost and Chief Academic Officer has. Recognition of our students is the most rewarding. This honors convocation and the two annual commencement programs that occur at the conclusion of the fall and spring semesters are the most important events of the academic year. So we are honored that you are with us this evening. It's my pleasure now to introduce to you our guest speaker, Dr. Martin Giesen. Of Dr. Giesen, you think immediately of something larger than a single individual. You think of this institution. Dr. Giesen has been at the American University of Sharjah since January 1st, 1998. He was the founding dean of this university's School of Architecture and Design, which is now known as the College of Architecture, Art, and Design. Born and schooled in Germany, he earned his PhD at Heidelberg University, and then later interned at the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York. He has taught in Lebanon, Saudi Arabia, Canada, and most recently here at the American University of Sharjah. For 30 years, Dr. Giesen has produced and exhibited watercolor paintings documenting the impact of development on the human environment. His work has been shown in solo exhibits in Lebanon, Germany, Canada, and the United Arab Emirates. Dr. Giesen this evening will give us some reflections on the role of the professor, and in particular, the importance of being a mentor. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Giesen to the podium.
Dear honor students, dear parents, dear guests, dear colleagues in this noble enterprise that we call the American University of Sharjah. Today's Thursday, and usually on Thursday evenings, I have a tennis date with the university librarian. And when I expressed to her regret that we wouldn't be playing tonight, she told me that this event is her most favorite event because she is together with the smartest students. And then she did something interesting. She made a gesture and pointed to imaginary students and said, "Library, library, library." She recognized among the smartest students the most faithful clients of the university library. Can you sense the energy in this room? Do you hear a bit of a fuzzy noise of energy colliding? That's the particle of the smarts.
Thank you.
Did someone in your life engage you in questions that have no easy answers? Or many different answers? Did someone help you to be comfortable talking in public? In my large enrollment course with 240 students, I walk around with this lapel mic and I address students. And I tell them that one of the objectives of our education is to make them comfortable in oral communication. It takes a lot of encouragement and opportunity to do that. But again, my father was a role model there because at the dinner table, in order to entertain us children, he would sometimes ask us to make an impromptu speech. Talk about the knife. Talk about the scissors. 1 minute. Go. My sister hated it. Did someone help you learn to drive and put on the seatbelt before starting the engine? And I all doing it when you leave tonight? Was a teacher in the school someone who would write a meaningful critique in her assessment? A critique that you have never forgotten? An assessment that you still feel was right? Did a friend at school have the courage to tell you that oral hygiene is important to combat halitosis? And then maybe Google with you the meaning of that word? How did you get to be where you are? How come you are one who is honored here today? Who assisted you in language? I would like to ask all of our honor students here, how many of you have English as a native language, as a mother tongue? Raise your hand. Look at this. There may be 20, 95% are working in a new language. Who helped you to become fluent in this? Mentors and mentoring. That is what this little talk is all about. You probably have all heard of Odysseus. Homer wrote about him. He fought in the Trojan War, didn't know how long he was going to be away from home. And he put in place someone to take care of the palace and the education of his son. And that man was Mentor. And that gave us the name for that particular role of a trusted friend, an advisor, a teacher. Do you know how long he was gone? 20 years. 10 years fighting the war, and 10 years finding his way back. A lot of mentoring had to be done in the meantime. And mentors come in many guises. They come as parents, they come as sisters, they come as cousins and friends and aunts and teachers. They come as librarians and coaches, as sponsors and tutors and masters. In the Odyssey, Athena, the goddess Athena, appears as a mentor. And I am not too shy to say that I also wish that God would be my mentor sometime. But this evening is about you, honor students, and your future as mentors. Because I call on you to pass on the gifts that have blessed you to your younger peers. Become advisors, trusted, experienced, to help those that follow you, to optimize their educational experience, to assist them to socialize into the culture. culture of your discipline. To give emotional and moral support, to give feedback on performance, and to be models of identity, living the life of a student in exemplary fashion. I thank Provost Karamanyan for the opportunity to talk to you about mentoring and ask you all to join me in applauding our honor students and future mentors. Thank you.
Now, does that want to make you come back to university? Let's give them another round. Dr. Giesen, for those remarks, reminding us that there's so many people in one's life who can serve as mentors and affect people. Thank you. The American University of Sharjah is a very special university. It's a testament to the vision of His Highness Sheikh Dr. Sultan bin Mohammed Al Qasim, a member of the UAE Supreme Council, the ruler of Sharjah, president of the American University of Sharjah, and founder of this university. This university is very rigorous academically, yet it's much more. The American University of Sharjah is an intellectual hub. It's a place that encourages students to see the world in a new way. Little did you know, honorees, that when you first arrived on campus, the challenges you would face. You quickly understood and embraced them. Your dedication has borne fruit and distinguished you from your peers. Each of you has talent. Your hard work, commitment, and perseverance, however, have enabled you to rise to the top. Your discipline and focus in balancing time between academic and extracurricular activities are no doubt important ingredients in attaining success. No person can do this alone. Along the way, as Dr. Giesen reminded us, your parents and other family members have been a source of guidance and care. They have made sure, through their own hard work and sacrifices, that you were given the opportunity to attend the American University of Sharjah, and that you could succeed in your university education. Besides your parents, there are members of the faculty. They have been your instructors and mentors. They have provided you with knowledge and tools to reach your goals. When you succeed, the faculty succeeds. The AUS staff has been significant in its contribution to your accomplishments and success as well. Honors Convocation 2017 is a very special evening. It recognizes you and your accomplishments. And it makes us all proud of the proven excellence of you as students of AUS. I would like to extend my personal congratulations to you on your success. And I would also like to congratulate your families, relatives, and friends. Thank you very much. Now for the presentation. Tonight we are celebrating the academic achievements of 411 students. These students have been named to the Chancellor's List, which is the highest academic attainment a student at AUS can achieve. It's nice, isn't it? brings a wonderful pleasant. That's okay. To qualify for recognition on the Chancellor's list, a student must submit the following requirements. 1, figured out how to turn the device off. Named to the Dean's list in both the fall 2016 and spring 2017 semesters, and have earned at least a 3.5 grade point average. 2, registered in a minimum of 15 credit hours each semester. 3, had no incomplete or failing grades in any course. And 4, had no disciplinary action. Ms. Salma Al-Assar from the Office of the Registrar will now call the names of the Chancellor's List honorees.
محمد بسام الحفيظ shut up. Adol must stay the team. Apurva Mandar Betsho. Ilsha Duryani. Beshwa Batni.
Yeah. Thank you.
Someone. Krishna Pramod Pelemari. Iman Muhammad Siddiqui. Anfar Bachi Sayyid Ali. Nafiha Asad Khan. Hadifa Abdul Latif. Fatma Maher Hussain. Ahmad Hamad Irfan. Delma Ahmad. Obaida Ismail.
Muhammad Rashid Matrushi.
chancellor's last for 3 or more years.
Thank you. صورته بس الناس قامت
يا مان
فتحات
يا مان فتحات سيدرا عزام أنا ميكا سينغ أنيكا بوكشانزاني أجن جيكو برو وينان نايش تفوني ساشن نايش
Oh,
Thank you so much for coming.